Good morning, guys. This is a Friday during the summertime, and I have nothing planned for today, and I'm so thrilled for that. So this morning I woke up and was like, let's go thrifting. I haven't been thrifting in, I feel like, a while, just like a genuine thrift trip. And so Amanda, me, and my mom are all gonna be going to the thrift store. I thought I would take you guys along, do a little like 2017 Marla throwback, and bring you guys for the journey. So it's gonna be super fun. Okay, so here's the outfit of the day. I have this top from PacSun, and guess where the jeans are from? These are also from PacSun. And then I'm wearing my waterproof Tevas. I've been wearing these so much lately because they're like as comfy as Crocs, but they're not as ugly, which is a little debatable, but I have been wearing them so much lately and I love them. So I then have some jewelry from Every Jewels for my earrings, the ring that I made. Like, I wear the same jewelry every day. So, oh, actually this one's from Ava Jewels X En Route collection. And then this one's also a ring that I made. So there's the jewelry for today. Let's go shopping.
Hello.
Alexa, take care of Alfie.
Okay, say hi.
Hi.
What are we looking for?
Clothes.
Girl. No, right now we're in the men's section because the men just always have better pants. They're always like way better quality. Even if we can find some, we can like turn to shorts. Those are overalls.
No way.
This looks like the toilet.
That kind of does. Well, right now we're in the flannel section. We're trying to find some shirts we can maybe layer underneath sweatshirts. I got this one. I think this is from Target, but I thought the checkered pattern was cute. Look at that one. That one. I kind of like this.
That's so cute. The butter yellow.
Okay, so a little tip for you guys is if you want that Brandy Melville t-shirt look, just go to the little boy section and then they fit like way smaller. But you still get that like boyish look. So, Amanda, what do you think of? Urban Outfitters has literally been doing these half and half shirts so much, and look what we just found.
That is cute. I like.
I think
they would fit.
I think they would fit.
I mean,
me
they're stretchy
too.
In the back.
They're stretchy.
I would totally wear those.
I would totally wear.
They have such cute little hooks.
They're all so tiny. Okay, so we have like a ton of stuff in our cart, and we were gonna try it on in the dressing room, but the dressing rooms are closed. So we're probably just gonna pick out what we absolutely love and then kind of do like a try and haul at home. And then whatever we don't like, we'll probably re-donate back to DI. What's next? We're sorting through everything that we like. So far we like those two things we want to get for sure. I think this is kind of cute. I like the colors. Okay, then hold that. I feel like we have to get the Dodgers one. Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, and it's an extra small. This would look cute on you, per jeans.
Girl, Jennifer Lopez, I have to. Okay, what do you think of this like unbuttoned with like a pair of light wash jeans? Okay, well, let's get that then. What? You're so judging me right now because I picked up this dress. Girl, you're judging me. It looks like a choir dress. Aww. And then I want to get these books. This one is about joy. This one's about having no doubt. My dad used to read this book to us and I actually really liked it. Yeah, and then this is like a fashion forward book and it's so cool. So this is like the most magical sound.
Grandma Kobe made
them smaller. Grandma Kobe would have to like reduce everything.
No, but still.
But those are cute. Grandma Kobe's gonna be put to work today.
Honey, it's gonna be so big. You put both your legs in there.
Girl, but that's the look.
It's supposed to.
All of this for $67. Well, Amanda chipped in 20.
Well, I need both of those.
Big girl. Look at all that. Okay, guys, we are back in the car and that was so successful. Thrifting gods were pleased with that today. I just had a list. The thrifting gods were so happy today and we had a lot of success. Because I couldn't try on anything because the dressing rooms were closed, I bought some stuff that I'm kind of unsure about, but I'm gonna go home and try it on and then do like a little haul. Amanda and I can do that. So stay tuned for that. So you get the thrifting vlog and haul all in one. That's the plan for today. Probably gonna go to Costco and eat some pizza. It's gonna be great.
Hi guys, hello beautiful people of the tubes. Today's the next day and it's almost 2 in the afternoon and I thought I would now film the haul. Yesterday just life happens, running errands, and I was like, okay, I'm just not gonna film the haul today, so now's the time. I'm gonna make this pretty quick, to the point, and it's gonna be a try and haul, so let's get this party started. First things first, it was a good day at DI. I hadn't been there in a while, but like, I was very pleasantly surprised. Why does my hair look like LaFonda right now? LaFonda's actually so pretty, so
That's not a bad thing. Okay, so for starters, I got this button up. Whenever I go thrifting, I always say this in my thrift vlogs, but I always go straight to the men's section. They always have the best button ups, the best jeans, best t-shirts. They just really, that's where most of the good things are at. So, I got this really thick linen button up. It's like this creamy butter yellow. This is perfect for summer. If you guys have seen Matilda Jerf on Instagram, first off, you need to follow her. Like, she's one of those, like if you have Instagram and you're not following her, then you're not doing Instagram right, because she's just so, like, inspirational, very body positive, and, like, her fashion is so minimalist and very open and flowy and summery. So, anyway, she wears a ton of button-ups, and this one reminded me a lot of her style, and I love it so much. So, I'm excited to use this as like a layering piece for the winter and then also for the summer. Like, I wore it as a swimsuit cover up yesterday because I ended up going to the pool. So it was really cute, very efficient, very versatile too. So next thing we have, I think Amanda actually chose this out, but this is another button up. This one was just more of a pinstriped blue. Okay, I prefer to film on the other camera, but the battery just died and I don't have any extra ones. So we're on the G7X now, which is not as good of quality, but it will suffice. Where I was at, I was talking about blue pinstripes, but this is just another button up. It's just like the yellow one except blue and pinstriped. And another, I feel like I'm gonna mention Matilda Jerf so many times in this video, but she has a clothing company called Jerf Avenue and it's really cool. I love it. But she has something called the Breezy set on there, and it is a lot more expensive because it's very sustainable, which is great, but like I feel like you can find dupes for the products that she has. And I feel like this looks super similar to her Breezy set. That's the next button up. Do you like my tripod? I'm gonna put on these earrings because I feel like I'm not complete without a little bit of jewelry. Okay, up next is this two-piece pants set. And when I saw this on the hanger, I was like, it's too good to be true. It's not gonna fit right. Girl, it fit right. It was so cute and I'm so stoked for this. It's the prettiest green. It's this very earth toned green, like a sage color, and it's a linen suit. And the pants fit honestly great. They're a little snug around the butt, but like I'm not complaining. Makes me look slim thick. And then the matching top is the short sleeve button up that has shoulder pads. And I'm not sure if I'm a big fan of the shoulder pads on me. I feel like it makes me look like a football player. And so, but like I could easily cut them out. So you'll see when I'm doing the try on portion, but I just think this is so cute. I think this was 20 bucks. Thrift store prices have definitely gone up, but like, still 20 bucks for a really cute pantsuit, like top and bottom. That's a great deal. So love that. I'm gonna be wearing that a ton. Okay, Amanda picked these up. I didn't choose these out, but I'll just show them still. I don't even think I'll try them on because I highly doubt these are gonna fit. But Amanda got like this dark wash pair of jeans. I think these are from Aeropostale actually. And I do not think these are gonna fit her, but she thinks that my grandma Kobe's a wizard, so she's gonna like hem it all. Maybe she will. And then Amanda got these Dickies one. These are literally not her size, like not even close to it, but she'll make it work, don't worry. Up next is this. I'm kind of like, you know those purchases, like the next day you're kind of like, why did I buy that? This was one of those. I also didn't realize the size, so like, anyway, this is a bathing suit top. What if I just wore it like this? I was kind of like in a 2000s mood and I was like, oh, like Sharpay Evans, like I could make this work. First off, this is a size large and I didn't realize it, so the boobs is like way too big. And then secondly, I don't have any swim bottoms that would like match this, so that's my story. Like, this is an item like I bought that I didn't think to style with anything. And I feel like that's something I need to work on more, is when I'm shopping and I buy a piece of clothing, I can ask myself like, can I style this piece of clothing with stuff I already own? And that was one of them. Like, I don't know how I'm gonna wear that. So I don't know why I bought it. Up next, I got this blazer and I'm really excited for this for more fall time. I know in the thrift vlog I mentioned how I didn't want to buy something because I can't wear it till fall, but this, I feel like this was good. It's this black blazer and it also has shoulder pads and it's just slightly cropped because I did find it in the women's section, so it's definitely a more feminine fitting blazer. And I thought this would be really cute with like a dainty dress under it for church and some like black high heels. Yeah, girl's gonna be going to the singles ward. If you're a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, then you know what I'm talking about. Your girl's maybe gonna be wearing a blazer to church. I don't know. This was another purchase. I was like, why? Okay, in my defense, the dressing rooms were closed, so like I couldn't really try on a lot of the stuff. I couldn't try on anything, so I kind of was guessing. And this is one of the items I was very unsure about. And it's not like awful, but it's not cute. So it's just like a, anyway, but it's this two-piece set I also got, and I was like, oh, maybe I can like pull it off and make it look like cute vintage grandma, but like it just looks like grandma and like minus the cute and vintage. But I mean the top's actually not bad, but it's this very fall autumn-y looking, is autumn-y? Did I just really make up that adjective? Very autumn inspired. It has this like really cute faux velvet collar, and then the matching bottom piece was a dress that looks like a skirt because the top is like this and then the rest is a skirt. So then you'll just see when I try it on, because I feel like it's hard to explain it, but it's, I feel like it would be cute if I really had like good makeup on and like a really cute slick low bun with some big statement earrings. This is an outfit that I definitely would have to style and dress up in order for it to look good, because I don't think it would look good on its own. But you know, if one morning before church, like I wake up and have enough time to do it, then like, why not? That's that item. Okay, and then up next, I have a bunch of t-shirts that I got. T-shirts, at the end of the day, I feel like I end up living in t-shirts during the summertime, just because I'm like going on a walk in the morning, I'll put on a t-shirt. I'm going to bed, I'll put on a t-shirt. I'm after swimming, I'll put on a t-shirt. It's just, t-shirts are the way to go for me. I always like to be stocked up on a bunch of cute tees. Like I said in the vlog part, I went to the little boys section to find more Brandy Melville fitting shirts. These are the ones that I got. Hello.
Can I come in?
Yeah. Okay, my favorite Sam came in, so I had to stop and talk to him. I would say favorite brother, but love you, Nathan. Anyway, the little boys t-shirt section, it's great if you want more of that tighter fitting shirt with the fun graphic tees. I got all these shirts from that section. I got the Dodgers LA shirt. I have the Dodgers hat. I have two of them, and I wear them all the time. Do I watch baseball? That's a personal question. My mom actually went to, I think, the LA Dodgers game like growing up, because my grandpa really liked baseball, so I'm not like, no, I'm a fake fan. I think it'd be fun to go to a game, but like I'm not invested in the teams at all. I just like the logo. Anyway, call me a fake fan in the comment section down below. Will it hurt my feelings? No. I got that shirt, and then the next one was this. It's like a little Boy Scouts t-shirt, but I like the coloring and I thought it was fun. It says Troop 188. It's like the periodic table of elements, but C is for camping and S is for swimming, and LS is for life saving. Can't cheat on my science test with this, but it'll do. And then the last t-shirt that I got, I had been on Urban Outfitters not that long ago. I feel like my hair looks like a sprout. Just don't look at it, close your eyes. It's cause I have two cowlicks right here, so it like, but I was on Urban Outfitters website and on their graphic tees, they had quite a few, and they had some sweatshirts where it was like half a shirt sewed to another half, so they're two different. And I saw this one, and this is literally exactly what Urban Outfitters has been doing, except this one was $2 instead of a $30 graphic tee. And it's cute, it's fun, tucked into like mom shorts with some sneakers and socks. I'm ready to go play soccer and to play some sport. Just kidding, you know I won't do that. Okay, and then the last item that I got for clothing, Amanda actually picked this up, but literally the best thing about having sisters, especially Amanda and I, is we're so similar in size that like both of our closets are just one. Like she comes into my clothes all the time, I go into hers, and like we just share clothes. If you have siblings that are trying to share clothes, like I think my biggest piece of advice is just let them share it. First off, it's literally a piece of fabric, like just do it. It's just nice because then it's like, hey, like as long as you like return the clothes and they're not scraped up and dirty, like continue wearing them. And so like we just do that all the time, and so whenever I buy new clothes, like she gets new clothes, and when she gets new clothes, I get new clothes, and it's just fun. And we have the same shoe size too, so it's like we literally all just share everything, and it's my favorite thing in the world. So Amanda picked up this red, very heavy, but this will be great for the fall time, and I love how vibrant it is. Or even like going to a carnival at night. I went to a carnival last night actually, so this would have been perfect when it's a little bit cooler for those summer nights. This is such a fun red, and you can just layer it with like a little mini dress. Okay, and then that's it for clothing, but I got three books that I just wanted to show. Thrifting books is actually like, it was awesome. I was like, wow, I really, oh, I got four books. I didn't even realize that. Okay, a lot of these books are religious ones, but I love it. So this one's No Doubt About It. It's by Sherry Dew, who's a woman leader in our church, and she's awesome. I love her. I've listened to some of her talks before, and like she's just such a powerful person and like so spiritual, and I love her insights. So this is her book, and it literally looks brand new. Like whoever owned this and donated it, like I don't even know if they read it, because it feels brand new. The next one is called Joy, and it's all these different accounts of women in the gospel and their different experiences, and I love reading other people's experiences, and I think it'll be cool to learn from all these stories. And what I loved about this book is that it's kind of, honestly, when I was reading this, I was like, should I be reading this? Like, this sounds personal. But it was this girl named Maureen, and she like writes, Dear Mom, and then she like goes on to write her message to her mom in this book, and it was dated October 1980. So I just think that's really cool, and I'm excited to read more about all this. And for me, I feel like if I'm reading like a like a dystopian fantasy book. I can mow through that in a day. I can read books so fast, but more of these gospel religious books, I feel like I read smaller doses over time, so they take me longer to finish, but I love just having them on hand. The next one is this one, it's Boys Who Became Prophets. My dad actually used to read this book to me like all the time growing up. I remember him just sharing stories from it and always loved hearing it and learning more about the history of the leaders in our church, and I always thought that was cool. So I'm excited to read that one a bit more. Plus it was $1.50, so I was like, yeah, I'll take it. And then this one was like, I was like, wow, I'm like, the eye's really coming through, but the cover just says shoes. But the inside of the book is so cool. It's pretty much one of those like coffee table books. It has just all these like cool illustrations and edits. Like I love it. I think it would be a fun coffee book to have. Just collecting books. I feel like maybe you can have too many. Watch me end up on like the hoarder show and say, the girl who couldn't stop buying books. That is pretty much it for the haul, and it's kind of a weird hair day. It's like, what's going on? Oh dang, I wish I would have moved that because I feel like the yellow. Those are my tassel cords I have to give back to my friend. Anyway, that is pretty much it for this haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoyed watching this thrift with me video. I haven't done one of these in a while, and it just felt good to spontaneously go thrifting and to just have fun and to bring you guys along for it. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, you know the drill. Thumbs up, subscribe, comment, share with your mom, share with your dog. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye. Follow me on Instagram if you want to see really awesome outfits.